always miss something, right? Seniors of 2018, what a feat that we are completing today. Let me just say that it is an honor to be speaking to all of you, to the dads and the moms who are so proud of their sons and daughters, to all the congratulators for what we are going to become in the future. Let me say that I'm also honored to be representing my culture and my ethnicity on this stage today. And to that, I start off. Bienvenido, bienvenido, clase de 2018, al momento más memorable de nuestra vida hasta la fecha. Hoy es un momento para recordar el pasado, pero enfoca tus ojos en el futuro. Hoy es un tiempo de realización y alegría, la risa y la mente abierta. Es un momento para reconocer la fortaleza que tienes, para seguir un camino de propósito, presencia. Nadie dentro de este campo debería sentirse como si existieran sin un propósito. Usted está aquí, nosotros estamos aquí, clase de 2018. Por la gracia de su propia determinación, ustedes estamos aquí. Nadie puede quitarte eso de ti. Es su motivación lo que le da la bienvenida a ese diploma. Es tu orgullo el que plantó una semilla en ti mismo para terminar la escuela con tanta pasión como cuando lo comenzaste. So welcome, welcome, class of 2018, to the most memorable moments of your life to date. Today is a time to remember the past, but focus your eyes into the future. Today is a time of fulfillment and joy, laughter and open-mindedness. It is a time to acknowledge the strength you have to pursue a path of purpose, honor, and presence. Nobody inside of this field should feel as if they exist without purpose. You are here, class of 2018. By the grace of your determination, you are here. Nothing can strip that away from you. It is your motivation that welcomes you to that diploma. It is your pride that planted a seed in yourself to finish school with as much passion as when you started it. You fostered a love for yourself to be responsible. No more moms picking out the clothes for you to wear. No more fathers spoiling you with their money on games or on the latest phone. It was your choice to wake up early in the morning, grab a quick breakfast, and ride out a storm that has lasted over 12 to 14 years of your life. And I have to be honest, that has been the most tiring of all, especially studying until 12 o'clock or until 6 o'clock in the morning without any sleep to study for these exams. And even then, some of you have found the time to sneak out of the house at 2 a.m., lay on a tin roof to catch the stars on the midnight canvas, and paint your dreams on the sky with your eyes wide open. Tonight is a dream worth having, my friends. So be proud of what you have accomplished to get you to where you are now. Do not be ashamed of how far-fetched your destination may be. Do not be ashamed of who you are expected to become. Do not limit yourself to small town ideals. Carry with you the love of yourself to achieve what you believe would be impossible. For some, today's graduation was something impossible. But for the rest of us here, sitting next to our best friends, or our enemies, or even our family, we conclude our last chapter of high school with a night for ourselves, for our generosity and our motivation to never forget all of our battles we pushed through and all the milestones we carved into our name, to revel in this bittersweet yet fulfilling and final moment. So it is you, class of 2018, who will march out tonight with as much feathers to flaunt on your side as in as much spirits to run with fever pride. Like a peacock, spread your beauty and your worth into an enormous display of gratitude, uniqueness, and pride in who you are and what you have been destined to become. So show the world today who you are and how you are someone to be proud of. Now, me saying this, I myself was not some person who was familiar with as much pride in the past as I was committed to today. It took a while for me to understand what it meant to be prideful. You can call it this a deadly sin for the egotistical, or you can call this a last resort towards receiving attention. Though, before you torpedo those words into our faces and bombard our self-esteem with that negativity, call it by what it makes one fear. For pride is placed simply as love itself. I want to start off by saying that I was not the most favorite child when I was younger. In the famous words from my second grade teacher, I was an embarrassment. I was scrawny and shy. I was tiny and sensitive. I stuttered when I talked and I waddled when I walked. Much like a penguin and the dolphin, which, by the way, I have this huge obsession over, where I still may or may not have a shrine of them sitting in my closet shelf. I know, it's weird, right? Let me also tell you that I was definitely not the smartest kid on the block. Math hated me, I hated it. Reading never caught my attention because I would always doze off into a fantasy in which I was the hero of some supernatural reality. This led me to basically cry all the time because I didn't know what the heck was going on. Believable, right? Yeah. Well, seeing me now, and all the accomplishments I have been through, I only changed because I wasn't proud of who I was. And I definitely did not want to disappoint all the expectations of who I needed to become. Expectations set upon me from pretty much everybody. Not just from my mom, but from my teachers as well. I had to be as smart as Elena Garcia. I had to be as athletic as Kat Rubalcaba. Or I had to be as friendly and as popular as Daniel Belmare. My friends that I was consistently compared to made me feel weak. Like a nail hanging tightly to its support, yet rusting ever so slowly until it begins to collapse on itself. I need not disappoint anybody any longer. So I studied for tests, tried my best to be a good kickball player, and kept away from all the quirks and tics that I did that seemed to be too weird in order for me to fit in. Is that weird? No, of course not. All of us just want to fit in, right? Regardless. But every time I got excited, wiggling my arms like a spaghetti noodle on a fork, that was still too weird. Don't do that in front of your teachers, I warn you. Or else they would just use you an example of what not to do in order to make friends. Heck, I will limit and admit that I was not proud to be me. Because I was always and always had to be somebody else in front of all of you. In all the variety of children that we met in our life, I was a child that nobody should be compared to. Never could you cry like a girl as Johnny. Never could you be as afraid of people as Johnny. Never could you look as skinny as Johnny. Never could you like to hide your skin, or sing a girly song, or freak out whenever somebody touched you as crazy or as annoying as Johnny. Never could you be, no. Never could I be as happy with myself for just being me as Johnny. I know, weird, right? Comparing myself to others. But do you guys know why I hide my skin all the time? It's much more than just a form of protecting myself from my germs. I hide my skin because of how uncomfortable it makes me feel, knowing that people will be able to shame me for my body, shame me for my sensitivity. Shame me for my crooked teeth and my large nose and the mystery that all my problems arise from. And yet, still shame me for trying to scrub off the very skin that offended the expectations with disappointment of just simply being Johnny. All these same shameful things about me, yet nothing to be proud of. And there was nobody who had wanted to be around a child like that. But let me also tell you that a few years later, I realized that I was not alone. I want my seniors to remember their first years of high school. You found musicians, athletes, actors, and animal showmen. But there were also book lovers, slaves to courage. Your gamers cultured with power, and your stargazers, grim and always going with wisdom. All of these kids had their own insecurities, but they used their insecurities to go home and where their true selves became something of a proud symbol for acceptance. Think of Rolandria Hemphill for a second. Did you know that she is much more than just a singer? She is also a person with passion for zodiac signs and rock music. Sometimes she's afraid to show that part of herself in front of all of you, because they are not traits that are associated with her social status. But inside her wife's dying family, she can go on and on about how the stars align to predict the moods of both your friends and of her friends, and the strength of every relationship that she has ever had. What she was ashamed for, she nurtured it into a community of acceptance. For me, it wasn't until I met Mr. Joe on the stage for the dark and the third that I find a home in the teaching for traits to accept it. We're grown into a fruitful garden for me to revel in. Mr. Joe is to me what a clockmaker is to a woman. When I first came into the drama club, he allowed me to become someone who amazes my audience with just my presence, alone. He whittled me into not being ashamed of my weirdness and my anxiety, because those traits foster performances that I should be proud for. Let your talent do all the driving for you, he said. Once those curtains open up, it is on you to show those people who know nothing about you what great things you are capable of. Well, Mr. Joe, I'm here, as I promised you. On my last performance for Rice House First Stage, allowing my talents to brag about all the hard work I have done to deserve this spot and to be somebody who should never be ashamed of. So to the class of 2018, as you walk on stage to get your diploma today, and as we wave our caps in the air and become as free as we want to be, stay proud of everything that you do. Flaunt it in front of yourself. Flaunt it in front of your friends. Flaunt it in front of all the naysayers that keep you grounded in this small town idea. Flaunt it in front of the world who is destined to follow you in suit and be proud of who you are. Drea, be proud that you sing to us with so much soul that you can hear the heavens sing back to who you are. Never be ashamed of what you have accomplished, class of 2018, or for being yourself. Be proud when you walk up on stage tonight. Tegan, be proud to be a black woman in the top 10% of your class and reaching for success. Blake Ponton, be proud that you go beyond your comfort and check up on the safety and happiness of your friends outside of your own home. William Duggar, be proud that you will be in all of our hearts as you go off and protect your family, your country, and to protect a legacy you made within this school and within this drama club, and sacrifice your life for the happiness of others. Maya Allen, be proud that you are with us in our prayers and love as a symbol for dedication to become a better you, so that you can walk across this stage with such power and such beauty and such motivation that you make yourself proud, but not just yourself and not just us proud, but make your mama proud. Christian Calvin, be proud that you have helped a little boy find security within his own skin, to be an inspiration to perform for the world and the memories of us saying together, I love you and I love you back. And right here, this is my final words at graduation. This is something that I'm going to be proud of. This is something that I'm going to be proud of all of you for. To be walking the stage with all of you and seeing how much each of you, how much each of us have grown to love ourselves since we took our first step at life. People like it when I sing songs now. People love it when I let loose and cry. People understand now that I was not afraid of people, but afraid that I would embarrass myself in front of all of them. As I march out tonight, as we march out tonight, I know what kind of impact we will be leaving behind. Because right now, I know that you guys are proud of me. I hope you guys know that I am proud of all of you. And I am proud of all of you for this very thing. And I learned today, and I learned throughout my whole years throughout high school, that slowly but surely, of what it takes to finally be proud of the friends that you were next to. But most of all, to find the pride to be proud of myself for just being John. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. It is an honor to be standing in front of you all today for this remarkable occasion. Family, friends, staff, administrators, and most importantly, my classmates. Over the last 4 years at Rice High School, we have grown together as a class and made memories that will last a lifetime. We have all competed with each other in one way or another, friendly competition that is, although I don't think it can get much worse than Johnny and Poppin's everlasting no I did better argument concerning their theater careers. Tonight, it is our very last time together as a class, so I would like to dedicate these last moments to honoring my classmates and thanking everyone who helped us to accomplish everything that we have to this day. 13, 14, 15 years ago, we all began riding the big yellow bus to a place called school. None of us, at the naive ages of 5 or 6, knew what we were getting ourselves into. All we knew was that we had to keep going back to that place for 13 more years. That was quite the commitment for a kindergartner, if you ask me. Now that we are seniors graduating high school, we feel the pressure of commitment upon ourselves again. The pressure to choose the right college, the pressure to find a career we will enjoy, and the pressure to make every right decision concerning the rest of our lives while we are still kids ourselves. We have all, myself included, found ourselves wondering what we will be when we grow up. We think about this all too often as if it is something that will fall into our laps and has already been decided for us. We just don't know it yet. But that's not how it works. Alan Kay, a great American computer scientist, once said, "The greatest way to predict the future is to invent it." Today, I declare that the class of 2018 stops imagining what our future holds and starts creating our future instead. With this being said, I urge every single one of you to take everything you've learned as a student at Rice, from every lecture given by a teacher, every lesson learned from your mistakes, to every meaningful conversation you held with a fellow student, and use it to invent a future personalized to you. While this is most definitely the most overwhelming opportunity we have ever been offered, with great possibilities come great risks, and with great risks come great rewards. As we continue making these life-altering decisions, it is important that we remain grateful for the people and memories that have led to this day. Thank your family for teaching you the importance of morals. Thank your friends for giving you a shoulder to cry on in your toughest times. Thank your classmates for their friendships and the lessons that they have taught you. And most importantly, thank God for allowing us all to come together as one today and providing us the guidance we have needed to make it as far in life as we all have been. There is one student, however, that couldn't be here today despite how much each and everyone wishes she was. Maya Allen was involved in an accident last April, leaving her in the hospital and ultimately unable to join us today. While she is not here in person, she is on our minds and in our hearts. We all pray she continues to recover in hopes of a happy and healthy life. The Rice High School class of 2018, while small in size, has an infinite amount of potential in their hands. It is tonight that we go off in our own direction, creating the future we have always wondered about. Some of us will jump straight into the work field, some will be attending a junior college or a university, and some will take time off to figure out what will be their own invention called life. Despite our differences, if any class can come out of Rice High School and be more successful than ever, I will place my bets on the class of 2018. I have witnessed firsthand everything that this class is capable of. This class is full of talented individuals, from actors to athletes and students to speech givers. Maybe I can call myself one of those now. As I conclude this speech, I want to wish my classmates, my friends, the best of luck. Deuteronomy 31:8 says, "The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. The future upon us is scary. Be determined, take chances, and leave the rest to God. Tonight, I want you to hug and thank every single person that you can. Take countless pictures with your classmates. Most of all, this is a night to remember. This is an accomplishment to be proud of, class of 2018. We did it.